location. Similar to the app that Svetlana mentioned, we have another app which uses this GPS system. That app is named Indian Police at Your Call. As we all know, we need like security and safety wherever we go, at all times, everywhere. So for this, we have an app, Indian Police at Your Call, which provides us security and safety at all times. This app is used to locate the police stations, get the phone number, so that like we can contact them. This is how this app is used.
So mentioning the safety is about the apps. There is an app which is used for the safety for us. The app is named as Digital Locker. So this app is a platform where we can have all the documents safe. We no need to worry about of losing the documents or whatever. So yeah, the online platform which takes all your Aadhaar cards and your PAN IDs and all the things without any distress and keeps it safe wherever you go is a Digital Locker app.
Similar to what Mahima told, there is Aadhaar Setu app. This is mainly used by people who pay their taxes. This is related to income tax concerns of a taxpayer. Income tax department initiated this app. So this app provides us with provides us to file the income tax returns, locate tax return prepares and all those things. Along with this, this app provides calculators and other tools so that like we can calculate the taxes on our own and we can pay.
Next on our list is the Khelo India app. It mainly focuses on sports and fitness of the people. We can get various information regarding the various games and sports facilities in our locality. It also assesses the fitness of children so that they can stay healthy and they can stay fit.
Yeah, cleanliness is next to godliness. Yeah, from this saying, we know that a clean society leads to a healthier environment and a healthy us. So, if you had a pile of waste near your society or your locality, then don't worry. Just download the app Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. This is by the government and it is well verified. You just need to download the app, take a pic of the pile of the waste and just upload the same as the waste picture. And the municipality officers will be notified and they will do the necessary things.
Next comes the farmers. Farmers play a major role in our country. So there's a special app designed only for farmers. It's called the Krishi Kisan app. It's exclusively for farmers. We can learn about the best practices of cultivation. And also it helps in geofencing and also in geotagging of the crops so that the farmer can prevent his or her crops from pests.
Another important app is the consumer app. This is an initiative by the Department of Consumer Affairs, Government of India. Through this app, as we know, like consumers can file the complaints, queries, and all those things through this app. This app is available in both iOS and Android.
Next comes the UMANG, which stands for United Mobile App for New Age Governance. This is developed by the Ministry of Electronics Information. This is the app in which one and all purpose app, which is used for many purposes like booking your gases and checking your PF between Provident Fund and one app with the uses.
Now let me talk about my government app, my GOV app. This app promotes the participation of Indian citizens in the governance and the development of the country. This app was launched on 24th of July 2014. This is the first app which got collaborated with Google. This app is available in both Hindi and English. This basically provides citizen engagement platform. The main aim of this app is to reduce the gap between electorate and executive after being elected.
Next on our list is the ePathshala app. This app is exclusively for students and teachers. It provides the syllabus and also it provides a wide range of information regarding the educational purposes. It comes in handy for the students as well as the teachers. As we read books and all online and Kindle and all that, this eBaatshala app provides e-books for the teachers as well as students in mobile as well as in desktops. So during this lockdown period, I think this app will be really useful for the students to improvise their knowledge.
So keeping things handy and using it usefully, we have the next app, BHIM, which is stands for Bharat Interference for Money. This makes India cash free. During this lockdown, we are all in the urge for the use of money. So here is an app which can be used during this lockdown usefully. This has been developed by the National Payment Corporation of India. This is unlike the digital wallet. It is used for the transfer of money from the bank account to another bank account directly.
Now let's talk about online RTI. As you all know, the RTI stands for Right to Information Act. Using this app, citizens can request for information from central or state government offices and departments. There are several steps in which you can apply through this, as how this works. The first step is the online application, which is available in that app, and you can pay also during applying this thing. Next thing is the expert. You'll get a call from the expert. Then you have to send, and they'll send you this RTI application to your mail. You can either approve it or edit it. Now this will be sent to the concerned officer or something. And after that, you'll be getting the tracking ID so that you'll be able to get the exact information that you want.
Okay, so next app is the Sangam app. This app is used for listening to devotional as well as the Indian classical music. This features over 2,500 devotional tracks in more than 24 Indian languages on a theme such as mantras. It also has songs from the classical music artists like Padma Shri Bhimsen Joshi, Ustad Bismillah Khan, and the other musical artists.
Yeah, so the next app is a useful app which is called as the GST Rate Finder. So this is to learn the current and applicable GST rates. This has been used by the accountants and all the people for the knowing the GST of the products available. This has been developed by the Central Board of Excise and Customs. This is useful for you while you're shopping.
Next app that I would like to talk is about M-Passport Seva. As you all know, passport is one among the things that we all need. So this M-Passport Seva helps us to know about the passport application status, the tracking of that, and then locating Passport Seva Kendras, and deals with various steps involved in getting a passport. This is also a free app, and this is available in both iOS and Android.
Okay, so the next app which I'm going to talk about is the C-Vigil app. This is for free and fair elections to happen. An app by the Election Commission of India that helps in creating a fast-track complaint reception and redressal system regarding the elections in our country to carry out the election processes in a safe and secured manner. So in this show, we discussed in a few apps introduced by our government of India for the benefit of the people. Hope it was very useful to all of you. So stay tuned. You are listening to PSG Community Radio 107.8 for this first community radio, Voice of the Folks. This is Ajay Spachana.
Ajay Mahima.
Ajay Mahima.